Candy Bar, London's famous lesbian bar. Sitting bang in the heart of London, hundreds of women hang out at this popular bar every weekend.
It's a whole new world.
Last week, Alex got engaged in Paris.
Oh, wow.
Danny got a new outfit. And emotions ran high at the fetish night.
You want to cause a drama and argue with me about it? Fine, I'm here for you.
This week, Danny needs a new flatmate.
She doesn't like it. We're fucked.
Natalie moves to London to join her lesbian twin sister.
Freaking out. Quite a little bit now.
And it's Valentine's Day.
She doesn't need to think about what I like. She just knows. It's amazing.
In East London, the face of the candy bar, Danny Orsi, is having a bit of a rough ride. She's just split up from her long-term girlfriend. Her best mate, Bex, is moving out, and so she now needs a new flatmate.
Bex, when are you starting your packing?
Are you trying to get rid of me? Is that what it is? I've ordered some boxes, so as soon as those boxes get here, I'm on it, like a gin and tonic.
Wow.
Don't even worry about it.
I think I'm going to be sad.
I'm going to be sad also. Obviously not as sad as you are because I'm an awesome flatmate and you're a bit of a tramp.
A perfect flatmate for Danny and has to be someone that doesn't mind sharing their stuff, someone that doesn't cry at the sight of a kitchen full of washing up, someone that has a pair of slippers so they don't get crap all over their feet just walking from their bedroom to the bathroom.
Luckily, the candy bar grapevine has been working overtime and Danny's getting ready to meet a prospective flatmate.
In half an hour, I've got someone visiting the flat to look at the room. So, hopefully, with the flat in its very clean state, she'll like it. Because if she doesn't, we're fucked.
She is 22-year-old hairdresser Natalie State. Identical twin sister of Kaylee.
When obviously my dad found out that I was gay, I think, you know, it was like a big, like, whoa, okay, that's a. Don't really think he was expecting it. And then obviously when Kaylee came out, I think it, like, reality sort of hit him, like, wow, okay, you know, that's both my kids. We don't really go for the same sort of people, but about 4 years ago we did have a bit of a run in. I was sort of seeing someone and this person was a bit. Become a bit obsessed, and I was like, look, babes, it's not gonna work. Next thing I know, she's getting out with my sister.
Kaylee has moved out of the family home in Surrey and now has a job as well as a flat in London, which she shares with long-term girlfriend, Kylie.
So, no, not jealous of her at all with her happy relationship and her cats and her nice little flat and good job. No, absolutely fine. Yeah, love it.
And now Natalie has also decided to fly the family nest and follow in her sister's footsteps.
Hello.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
I'm here to see the room.
Oh, let's have a look. Apparently we're having a party too.
Yeah. And by the way, I'm not actually the waiter.
Okay. Yeah. I'm here. Damn.
She's the bitch moving out. But apart from all that shit, this is the kitchen and normally it would be clean, but a lot of stress has been happening, so I didn't do it. So I apologise.
Natalie, do you want a drink to take around with you there?
Sure.
Great.
Oh, this is, will be your room once Bex moves out.
Yeah.
I don't think you get to keep the fairy lights.
I like it.
Yeah?
Is the bed still going to be there? Or?
Yeah, this will be here. This will be here.
All the furniture is staying, and I'm leaving that really poorly constructed bookcase.
Oh, wow.
Where's your room?
My room, but it's messy. But you don't need to see that room. Well, okay. I mean, you can see it, but don't. Okay.
That's the room, really, really quickly. It's lovely.
Yep.
A lot of history in that room, I can feel.
But anyway, I'm going to get a drink. Sit in the living room.
Can we get drunk then?
What's with the stickers?
These are lesbian laws.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
That
Don't go back to exes.
First and most important rule. Don't sleep with men.
Despite the mess, the flat is a hit, and Natalie's keen to seal the deal.
No, obviously I need to talk to work, try and settle out a transfer and things like that, and then... But no, I think it's wicked.
Really?
Yeah, I think you guys are wicked.
I'm stressing so much,
Natalie. I just feel really sorry to you that I'm not going to be here.
So?
Yeah, I'm not coming. Because you're the gang of
it. I really, really like the house. I like the housemate. I'm sure it'll be fun with Danny and her crazy ways and forgetting her keys and just being bonkers. I love the mental shit.
Candy bar owner Gary Henshaw runs a string of gay bars in London.
To Candy bar.
But this is his first foray into the lesbian world. And it's been a steep learning curve.
Oh, Jesus wept. I need to try not to get fucking stressed.
He's decided that the staff he's inherited need a shake-up and has drafted in his right-hand woman, Sam Yonker, to whip them into shape.
There's a lack of structure in there. Sam's been working with me for years. Sam worked in there last weekend, and she felt that he could do a little more, just tightening up a little bit. Sam is now will be in charge of the venue from today. The girls, I think, I don't think they're going to have a problem with that. I think they're going to take it on the chin and realise that it's probably a better way of structuring everything.
I won't lie, I'm feeling a little bit nervous, but at the same time quite excited. The girls are lovely. I get on well with all of them. I want to sort of help them get a better operational system in place to have things run more efficiently for them.
Easier said than done. Coming up, one of the Candy Bar girls isn't happy.
Give you 5 seconds and I'm going to break the lens on that camera.
Candy bar owner Gary Henshaw has called a staff meeting to introduce Sam as the new bar manager. But Sam has got a work cut out managing the likes of bar supervisor Alex Umbers, a wild child from the Australian outback.
It's a very small town. We've got one nightclub. So the horrible thing is when you're a party animal like me, you tend to get banned from it. I did get barred from the one bar in town, whereas here, if you get kicked out of somewhere, it's like, oh, it's fine, I'll just go to the next one.
So far, Alex has been left to her own devices and is not used to being bossed around.
If I'm behind the bar, this is my area and no one can do anything here. If I'm behind here, it's like you're in my place.
Alex has got wind of Sam's arrival, but is oblivious to the full implications.
At the moment, Sam's just an extra set of hands. The bar's been running quite well with just me and Lily doing it because Lily does downstairs and I do top bar. So we don't want to throw anyone else into the mix. There was a bit of trouble at the start where everyone sort of thought, you know, is she going to come in? Is she going to be above us? Is she going to take our roles? But she'll probably just be, you know, a bar supervisor.
I don't want to ruffle feathers. I don't want to cause problems. I don't upset Lily. I don't upset Umbers or anybody. But I just think for the structure to work as well as it should, there should be one manager of the venue. At the moment, I sort of feel like there's an awful lot of chiefs and not enough Indians here. Mm-hmm. And I actually wanted to put a chief in that will work with everyone, and I'm going to put Sam in as a trial to be the top dog in here. I hope that that's going to work out well. I mean, is anyone have any negative concerns about that? I mean, Lily or Umbers particularly, are you feeling a little bit put out? If you know, speak freely. Do you think you're going to be able to work this one out? I don't mean to put you in a compromising position. I mean, let me ask you a question. Do you feel you can work with Sam?
Yeah.
It has to be someone that the book ends with, and that is Sam. Okay, thanks, guys.
Yeah, I think it went well. I think it went better than I anticipated, so... Everyone's got different personalities, everyone reacts differently to news, so it's just a matter of ironing out things when they happen over the next few weeks, you know. I just want to make sure everyone works well together, that there's no animosity.
For Alex, the news comes as a bitter blow.
I'll give you 5 seconds, and I'm going to break the lens on that camera, because I'm not in a great mood.
Fucking drench myself in cream and lick it off myself. That's what I'm going to do.
No. I expected a little bit of resistance, and I think there's a few feathers that have been ruffled a little bit. But I think Sam is clever enough to actually work away right in there, and by the end of today, it'll all be forgotten and forgiven, and hopefully, fingers crossed, everything works out.
Right, see you guys. Thanks again.
Yeah. 22-year-old hairdresser Natalie is moving wholesale to London. It's a life-changing decision, and she wants to talk it through with twin Kaylee, who's already settled in the capital.
Because we are twins, we do have that special little bond. Like, you know, if I ever get hurt by anyone, Kaylee's straight on the case, she's straight making sure that I'm okay. We do have a really, really close bond.
I confide in Natalie in a lot, and Natalie will confide in me in a lot. So when people upset her, it upsets me a lot as well, because I know maybe how she's feeling and things like that.
My shoulder to cry on.
Yeah.
When times are hard. I think she's putting on a big brave face, but I think it is really, really nerve-wracking for her. It's a very big step. I feel it's a sisterly duty to take her out, and, you know, we're there for each other at hard times, so this is when I step in.
So are you excited about moving in with Danny, or are you a bit nervous?
Both. I've only met her once. Yeah.
What's scaring you about it?
That I don't know her. Mm. I'm moving to London. I'm moving out of my house. I've quit my job. Yeah, freaking out. Caught a little bit now. Yeah.
Okay, so she works in the evenings and she likes going out and things like that.
Yeah.
And you like going out, but you like your night of quietness. How do you think that's
going
to go?
Yeah, I'm sure we'll have it, though. I'm sure she doesn't like going out every single night.
I just think as long as you know what you're doing, because me and Kylie thought long and hard before we moved in with each other. And, yeah, we do have our arguments and things.
But you didn't have a job, did you?
No, and I didn't have a job for 4 months, and I thought, handing my notice in, I'd find a job really quickly. Mm. But you don't.
OK, you're kind of freaking me out a little bit now. But then sometimes I think doing things on a whim are quite... It makes it more exciting. You know, you've made it, you've done well, so I'm just going to crack on and just do it. And just be excited. I'm moving to London, it's a massive thing.
Okay. Well, as long as you know my concerns, then I'll stick with you.
Yes.
I'll be with you throughout
this. They're in my head. They're in my head. They're in my head. Just a little bit of a change, I think, for 2011.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Natalie is keen for her twin sister to meet Danny to help put her mind at ease.
I don't really know much about twins. I've never really been friends of anyone that's twins before, but aren't they, like, really, really close? Like, not them in person, like, just general twins. They're, like, close. So maybe, like, I'm going to have two flatmates. Like, two-for-one deal.
Ooh. I want Danny to be very similar to what Natalie's like, so that they would get along very well. So Natalie's very bubbly, outgoing, but is also... He's also very kind and considerate, so I'm hoping that Danny is kind of on the same wavelength as Natalie.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm quite nervous, actually.
Are you?
What have you been doing today?
Waking up early and trying to disguise the flat being a mess. Been, like, doing the washing up and things. I was like, I can't get it all done, fuck. So I just thought I'd confess. Oh. It's a shithole, but it will be nice.
That's all right.
It's cool. Because I've just broken up with my girlfriend, and I was with her like 3 years and a half, and I'm like a little rebel teenager all of a sudden. It's like I can do whatever I want, you know, I'm single, I'm, you know, and I'm just like
crazy
scatty
at the moment.
Yeah, and I just need to, like, you know, start looking after myself again and things. Like,
yeah,
cool. Okay. I'll be saying to Natalie, my only concern is that you two don't know each other. You have no idea what your little bugbears are with each other. So she's a bit nervous. Are you a bit nervous about it?
I mean, I don't really think about things. I just go with the flow. And as long as I just be, like, really honest with each other. If I ever piss you off or something, just say, Danny, you're being a right cunt. And I'll be like, oh, sorry.
Brilliant.
Yeah?
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. She seems a bit mental, but how mental can you be on a Sunday afternoon in a pub? But they seem like they're going to get along very well, so fingers crossed to them, all the best to them.
Sam's first job as Candy Bar's manager is to get everything ready for a speed dating night.